a bit difficult because here the basic aim is to let go. Let go and enjoy. Subconscious going there starts with thoughts. The language of the subconscious is thoughts. Okay. And the vocabulary is imagination. So you start off by imagining. Everybody can imagine. So if you have to close your eyes and imagine a flower, you can imagine a flower. Everybody can imagine. So whatever I say, just imagine and shift your awareness to those areas as that energy. Everybody will have a different experience. I will ask you about your experience. Remember, there is nothing to be afraid of. You will not get caught in the subconscious. You will not get lost. You will come back. But if you have a fear, you will not be able to go away because your conscious will not let you. So, we have talked about the conscious and the subconscious. The unconscious is when you are not aware at all. And the superconscious is what we call the One. The One, the cosmic energy, the God, universal. That is superconscious. The mingling of the subconscious with the superconscious is what is the aim of all meditation. When you do dhyan, you go from many thoughts to one thought. From that one thought, you go to no thought. When you go to no thought, means you have become one with the superconscious. And that is the state which is commonly known as samadhi. Okay. So, I would like you to just relax, keep aside anything your hands are not. Sideways, good. Whichever. Make yourself comfortable. Just relax and bring your awareness to your breath. You can sit whichever way you want to, as long as you are comfortable. Just bring your awareness to your breath. And feel the breath going in as you inhale. Follow the breath and let it go in. And fill up your lungs with oxygen. And as you exhale, let this air come out. Let your awareness follow this air till the air comes out. Gently close your eyes and bring all your awareness to your breath. Take three deep breaths and as you exhale, say the word relax to yourself and then breathe normally and with every new breath, feel the breath going slightly deeper and the deeper it goes, more relaxed you feel. Close your eyes, let yourself be. Just follow your breath. As I count you down from 5 down to 0, you will go deep into a very relaxed state. 5, 4, 3, 2, 1, 0. Deep sleep. And with every new breath, feel the breath gets slightly deeper. And the deeper it goes, the more relaxed you feel. And the more relaxed you feel, the deeper you go. And the deeper you go, more relaxed. Let every breath make you go deeper and deeper, becoming more and more relaxed. Now shift your awareness to the small muscles of your forehead. Feel the small muscles of your forehead. Feel these muscles relaxing. As they relax, feel all the stress falling away. And now let this relaxation move down to your jaws. Unclench your jaws, let the muscles of the jaw relax. And now let this relaxation move down to the neck muscles. And you can move your neck sideways, both sides, so that you find a good place in which all the muscles feel most relaxed. Now, let the relaxation move to the back of your neck. That muscle in the back of your neck where stress resides, let the muscles relax. And as the muscle relaxes, you can feel your head becoming lighter and lighter. And let your head fall forwards so that your chin comes onto your chest. Let this relaxation move down to your shoulders. And as it moves to your shoulders, feel the muscles of your shoulders relaxing. And as they relax, you can move your shoulders and feel the stiffness moving away from the shoulders. And now let this relaxation move down your arms to your elbows, down your forearms to your fingers. Feel the fingers relaxing, and as they relax, they become heavy. But at the same time, they feel so comfortable. Put your fingers on your thighs or on the armrest of the chair if it's present. Spread your fingers. And now, using your inner strength, let the heat be generated in your fingers as if you have been warming them next to the fireside. And the fingers will feel nice and warm and heavy, but at the same time, so, so comfortable. And now let this relaxation move down your chest to your stomach, and down your upper back, middle back, lower back, relaxing the muscles of your back, loosening the muscles. And now feel this relaxation moving down your thighs to your knees, and down your legs, to your feet and to your toes. You feel the relaxation spreading to your toes. You can wiggle your toes. And as you wiggle your toes, you can feel the relaxation in your toes. And as they relax, you can feel them become nice and warm and heavy like the toes, same as the fingers of your hand. And your whole body is nice and totally relaxed. Focus on your breath once more. And feel the breath moving in. As it moves in, you go deeper and deeper, relaxing. And your breath slows down. You feel very, very comfortable. And any sound which you hear are just everyday sounds, and they will not trouble you, and will only make you go deeper and deeper. And the only thing you are aware of is the sound of my voice. And every word I speak will only make you go deeper and deeper. Take you deeper and deeper into your own subconscious space. And as I count you down from 10 down to 1 to 0, each count will make you go deeper, twice as deep, so that by the time you reach 0, you will be very, very deep in your own subconscious mind. 10. Deeper and deeper. 8, 7, 6, 5, 4, 3, 2, 1, and 0. You are now very deep in your subconscious mind. And now I would like you to imagine that you are in a beautiful healing space. It is the top of a mountain, a beautiful meadow. It is early morning. The meadow is green. There is a cool breeze blowing. Far away you can see the mountains. And deep below you can see a valley. It is early morning, smoke is coming out of the houses. You can hear the chirping of the birds. And as you stand over there and look down into the valley, far away you can see a few small houses and a small road. And on that road you can see two people walking up. And as you look at them, it is beautiful early morning. See them walking up. They become closer and closer and closer. And the road moves from where you are standing just beside you and moves up behind and goes across the mountain ridge to the other side. As these people come closer and closer, they come and stand next to you. And you have a small conversation with them. And now, they wish you goodbye. And they go on their journey, climbing up until they disappear from sight. And now you are standing there, alone in this beautiful space, enjoying the morning breath. And as you sit over there, feel the total relaxation in your body. Enjoy the calmness and the peace and the contentment. Whenever you feel any stress or anger or any emotional upheaval, just close your eyes and you will reach this place on top of the mountain. In this beautiful area where you can feel the peace and the calm. You can use this as a trigger to come here. Just close your eyes, say 1, 2, 3, clap your hands, and you will be here. Get in touch with yourself. And as you enjoy this view, very soon I'm going to count you out from 1 to 5. Before that we begin at 0. And each and every time I say the word 0 to you for the purpose of hypnosis, you will quickly, calmly and deeply to this level. Or even deeper. And the mind will be very calm. Start coming up with 1. I will 2. Further up with 3. Focus on your breath. Let the breath come. Feel the energy flowing. You are aware of everything with 4. And 5, eyes open. You can stretch your hands. You've just waken up from a deep sleep. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Eyes open, wide awake. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Eyes open, wide awake. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Eyes open. Okay. Who would like to share their experience? Okay. How many people could go and visualize the mountain?
Most.
Who could not? Okay. What did you imagine? What could you visualize?
Whatever you were telling.
No. They could not visualize. See, okay. Everybody doesn't. Because see, it is an imagination. Some people find it a bit more difficult. Some people find it Who are the two people? And I said two people were coming up.
I don't know where I was, but I did change.
Okay, okay.
I did change.
I saw that, but I didn't recognize.
Okay, what conversation did you have with them?
No.
Okay, anyone?
No conversation. They just inquired about me, how come I did it.
Okay. So do you know who those two people were? She's a very good client actually.
And then my great grandfather again was there.
Okay.
And he didn't want to leave me, but he wanted to say thank you to me.
Okay.
He has forgiven all those that
happened
in the past. My Nanima again came to take him.
Okay.
But again he went. But he again wants to have a home.
Okay, we'll talk about it. They are yes? So they passed away? Okay. What the conversation did you have with them? Okay. Okay. It's okay. See, these are some things which remain unsaid. Some chapter which is yet to be closed. Or there's something which you have to tell them, you wanted to tell them, but not tell them. So this is actually an issue which is left behind. So now you know, when we go there, you can solve these issues. When you were there, did you find it as if it is real? This is actually an experience. Maybe that is some topic which I'll discuss in my next time when I talk to you about the Kundalini and the chakras and how to activate and how to handle and what they are. That is the second part, maybe when we meet again we'll talk. So when you went there, those who could go, did you find a sense of peace?
Yes.
Relaxation?
Very relaxed.
Okay, that relaxation, that peace which you achieved, you can go there by saying 1, 2, 3 and clap your hands. But that is the trigger which has been set. So whenever you feel uneasy, distressed, distraught, close your eyes, imagine the meadow, say 1, 2, 3. It is a short way to relax you. This is just, I can give you an example of what scope hypnotherapy has. See, hypnotherapy, if you have pain, where do you feel pain? Pain. If you have pain, where do you feel pain?
Side of the pain.
The pain is on the side, but if you put a local anesthetic there, then do you feel the pain? Why?
Your signal is not inside.
So where do you feel the pain? You feel the pain here. This is just telling you that take care. Everything is felt. When we talk here, what is this? It is the brain. It is not the mind. Where is the mind? Mind is if thoughts are there, mind is there. If there are no thoughts, there is no mind. So in all your disease, your entire body starts off, it is created from one single cell. And a big you is created. So if one cell can make your whole body, why is it that if you have lost some part, you can't regrow it can. But we believe that we can't, so we can't. Everything is there in the belief. The limiting factor is our belief. If you are unwell, you can become well. If you have a disease, the disease can. Stage 4 cancers have disappeared. Chronic diseases for 20-20 years, they have disappeared. Provided you want them to disappear. If in hypnosis you find out that the reason for your problem is your anger with your mother-in-law, and fight with your mother-in-law, because of that you are having a back pain. So you have a choice. Either keep fighting with your mother-in-law and keep having the pain, or make peace with your mother-in-law and get rid of the pain. So the choice is yours. Hypnosis only tells you what is the cause. So if you go to a doctor, he gives you some medicine. The choice is yours whether you want to take the medicine or not. Many people say, no, I cannot forgive that person. I will stay with the pain, but I will never forgive. It's okay. Hypnotherapy is a very nascent field. In India, it is very, very nascent. In the West, it is growing by leaps and bounds. I go there, I am going there again in August, because I have been taking a talk on meditation and hypnosis as a combination in Las Vegas, where people from all over the world come, all hypnotherapists from US, UK, Europe, they all come. And in the US, almost all the large hospitals have got a department for hypnotherapy, where they work with pre- and post-operative treatment and classes. Frequently, when we say our awareness, our mind, it resides over here, there are instances, especially in post-transplant patients, a person who received a liver transplant, never used to like pickles. After the transplant, he could not avoid pickles. He could not eat anything without pickles. He wanted pickles. And when they found out that liver, the donor, was a person who used to love pickles, and in fact he had an industry of making pickles. So a liver transplant, this basically tells us that every single cell of our body is an entity by itself. So when you take something, even when you take a blood donation, you take a lot of the characteristics of the person. Things are not as simple or as straightforward as we think. There is a large grey area which we still have not been able to comprehend. Many of you, I think Chandigarh especially, it's a cleaner city. At night, when you look up into the sky and you see a clear sky with lots and lots of stars, look up at the stars and what do you think the stars are? Tare dikhte kya hai? What is the idea? What are the stars? Lot of news is there, India is sending rocket to Mars, planets. The stars are told that their suns, each has got lots of planets around them. So how many stars are there? Millions and millions. Each star is a sun, so there must be trillions and trillions of planets. So with so many stars and so many planets, do you generally believe that we are the only planet in life? So there will be life on other planets?
Maybe, but we don't know.
We don't. Why do we don't know? Because we have not been told.
Well, our comprehension is also limited. When
we don't know as yet.
Yeah, we might come to
Mars.
It's all perspective. सामने ला के तो खड़ा नहीं किया. See, there are a lot of questions. Many of you have got. I had a question. Near death experience. Many of you have heard about this. What is near death experience? So, in context to what I've already taught, suppose there is a body trauma and the person dies and the soul comes out of the body. And then the soul goes to the other side. Okay. The soul has a free will. So, it is a choice of the soul. So, if the soul doesn't want to, and if the body is still salvageable, you can come back. But if the body is not salvageable, then you remain as earthworms. So, many of the people who undergo a trauma in which that shock heals you, but your body recovers to survive again, soul can come back. It has a choice. So this near-death experience is this, and then they tell you what they have seen. And most of them have seen similar things. We do the same, which we call as life between lives. That is, one is past life, one is life between lives. When in your previous life, after you die, where do you go? Then you, before you are born. So that entire world which we say the realm of souls, you can explore. And there you can get answers to all your questions. All the people in your life, who are they actually on the other side? People who trouble you, who are they? Why do they trouble you? What is your life's purpose on earth? What are you supposed to do? It is all possible. Before that, the journey is there that you see your past lives, a few past lives, clean yourself of attachments, start working on yourself, let all these petty things like anger, these things go. Then you go. Lot of people have come. Kritika has come. Because, so she is in touch. She's undergone many sessions, so she goes. And once you go, then you know who everybody is there. So they seem very mystical and esoteric. But they are actually there. And the best proof of this is, if you have a problem and through this procedure the problem goes away, what else do you want? Pair mein darad hai, sabne try kar liya, theek nahi hua, is process se theek ho gaya. And if it is repeated again and again and again, it happens. See, I come from an area of pure science. I am a medical professional in pathology, where we talk about science in depth.
Science?
In depth, to write to the single cell. And after doing this, I realized that actually we do not know any answer. Any question, any disease you come to know, it all comes down to the end, which doctors have coined, idiopathic. Idiopathic means I don't know. For the common man, they think of cause is idiopathic. It actually means I don't know. So every disease goes to idiopathic. Diabetes, why it happens? No insulin. Why no insulin? Cells not producing. Why cells not producing? They have been destroyed. Who has destroyed them? Autoantibodies. Why have they destroyed them? Don't know. Last answer is don't know. So then if you don't know, how will you think? So to know this, you have to go into. You can't The moment you say that I know everything, that is the day you stop learning. The day you realize that there is, you don't know nothing, and you keep your eyes and ears open, you start learning. What I am sharing with all of you is, I am not telling you to believe what I am saying. I am just showing you a perspective. I am showing you a different picture, which, if it helps you, right? If it can answer a couple of your questions, fine. That you all have taken the pain to come over here is the biggest step you could have taken. After coming here, even if you don't believe a single word I speak, but it has gone into your subconscious. When required, you will get the answer. So you have seen a new direction, a new aspect of life. Right. So, I'm open to questions now. And let me see if I can answer your queries. Most of you must be having some question or the other.
But sometimes you have a chronic disease, but you can't pinpoint from where it started or how to go about that.
See, chronic disease normally, let me take it as chronic back pain. Very good. What do you do first? You go to a doctor. He will see, get an X-ray done. Nothing comes out, get an MRI done. Nothing comes out, but he will say something is there. Give you some medicines, ask you to go to a physiotherapist. Ask you to exercise, do yoga, etc. So you start doing. If your body wants to, it will become okay. If it doesn't become okay, then what do you
do? More medicine.
More medicine. That's the side effect of medicine. But then you don't want to take medicine. Then what? See, nothing happens without a cause. Bina karan kuch nahi hota. Anything to happen, something has to be the cause. So if you don't have an answer, then we go into hypnosis. We go to that area of pain. Then we ask that area, localize the pain. Ask.
What is your problem?
Who are you? What is the problem? It will tell you. If it is attached soul, soul will come up. You can talk to the soul. With kindness, love, why it has come here, phas gaya, nahi gaya, why did it not go? What was the reason? Make him happy, call a light and send it. The moment the soul goes next to you, see, where was the pain? It is not there anymore. It is that miracles. It could be a past life. How could it be a past life? See, all the phobias, you know what phobias are? Fear of
anything.
It's not actually fear. It is a fear, the cause of which we do not know. Fear is bachpan mein aag lagi ki tumhe aag se dar lagta hai. That is fear. Tumhe paani se dar lagta hai. Koi karan nahi hai, kabhi dube nahi. That is a phobia. Phobias are always past life. Kisi janam mein doob ke mare, is janam mein pani mein gaye dala, that subconscious will bring that experience of death, that fear up. So it will say, keep away from water. So you are afraid of water, not knowing. So when we go into hypnosis and take you, go to the very first time when you felt this fear, we'll take you back to a past life and show you how you drowned. So over there, we put that drowning in perspective, or we save you. And see, when you were in water, you could swim out and come out. Your fear in this life goes. There are so many people who have come who have been cured, who had fear of flying in aeroplanes, travelling in lifts. There were some ladies who could not go to the toilet. They had to keep the door open. in the past life, they were locked up in a dungeon and they died in a dungeon. Or there was a landslide and they got buried in the landslide. So these are phobias and fears. So these are past life. So but we do not know what is past life and which past life. If an issue is troubling you in this life, the cause could be anything. We go to the subconscious, subconscious will take you to the process.
If you have some persistent dream,
it is the subconscious trying to tell you.
After a while you don't have. For many years I had a dream that I was crossing a very narrow bridge with my hands and feet, and there was a river, flooded river underneath, and I was scared of falling into that, and very carefully I was trying to.
So, what
times the same thing happened.
And what was this age, what period did it live in?
How old I was when I had this? I mean, many times I had, even after marriage I had sometimes.
And when did it stop coming?
I don't know, it just suddenly stopped.
So, it could be a past life which got reactivated because you may have visited a bridge like this somewhere. Or it could have been an attachment which had died, which left by itself. They can go many times. You sitting in some religious place or mantra is going on, it's an opportunity. So they keep coming and they keep going. So when we are sitting over here, 50 people are here, there are 50 people we can see. There may be another 20 which we cannot see. No, there is nothing to be scared of. They are only souls without a body.
So by this science, can we cure stones also in the
gallbladder?
Everything?
See, you can do anything. But it all depends on your willpower to cure it. जो आंसर आपको मिलेगा आपको वो करना पड़ेगा कर पाओ मुझे देखो आई कुड नॉट डू इट यस आई हैड अ बिग किडनी स्टोन आई ट्राइड नॉट बिकेम वन फोर्थ देन अगेन बिकेम बिग देन अगेन बिकेम स्मॉल अगेन बिकेम बिग इन द एंड आई इग्नोर्ड इट एंड आई हैव लेफ्ट इट एंड नाउ इट इज नॉट देयर इट इज नॉट देयर इट इज गॉन वेयर इट वेंट हाउ इट वेंट अप. So things that keep coming and they keep going. Problem is, stone, if it has come, if the stone is bothering you and your mind is always there, it is occupying such a lot of your useful time. It is wasteful thoughts. See, emotional will eventually manifest as physical. Unless the physical is traumatic.
Physical is traumatic.
Traumatic means you have got hurt or you have got injury.
Yeah.
That can be healed because body can heal. If that trauma, that pain is without explanation, then the reason is. Then the reason always starts at the emotional level and manifests at the physical. See, what is there when we talk about the mind and the body and the soul? We talk about these three things. Remember, the mind-body is not separate. The mind and the body, the mind is the most subtle part of that energy and the body is the process. It is a continuum. A problem here will manifest there. A problem here will manifest. It is one. We are limited by our visual acuity. We can see a certain wavelength of light. White. Starting from violet to red. With clear. Out of that, infrared, ultraviolet, we cannot